young guy. Sikkelau, a little bit the taller of the two, has a little bit of a reach advantage against him. It's going to be interesting to see who dictates the tempo of this fight. Each man feels that he will be able to do that, and therein could be the story of our first fight of the evening. Let's take a look at the rules here in the state of Florida. 10-point must system. Three knockdown rule is, of course, in effect. Mandatory 8-count in effect. Cannot be saved by the bell in any round. The referee or the doctor can stop it. The accidental headbutt rule. We go to the cards at the end of four rounds. Right now to the center of the ring and the ring announcer, Thomas Trimer. Tom?
From the Mississippi Gaming Pavilion in Miami, Florida, Americal presents and the undisputed, undefeated king of beers, Budweiser, proudly present to you Fight Time on Fox. Let's get the action started. We have for you, first of all, 10 rounds of boxing in the lightweight division. And when the bell rings, the referee in charge of the action will be Jorge Alonso. Introducing to you first, fighting to my left out of the right corner, he's wearing purple trunks with white trim and weighed in at 138.5 pounds. A native of Havana, Cuba, he now makes his home in Hialeah, Florida, and has a professional record of 11 wins, 3 losses, 1 draw, with 6 wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Hitlip Lau. And his opponent, fighting directly across from him out of the blue corner, he's wearing red trunks with gold and green trim, and also weighed in at 138.5 pounds. Hailing from Accra, Ghana, Africa, he trains out of 10 Goose Boxing in Van Nuys, California, and has a perfect record of 17 wins, no losses, with 11 wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the current IBA Americas and IBF Intercontinental Lightweight Champion, Ben Wonder Taki. Wow. Once again, your referee in charge, Jorge Alonso, now to give the instructions.
Ben, right here. Chief second over here. All right, guys, we gave you the instructions in the dressing rooms, okay?
Right.
First and foremost, obey my commands. When I say break, I want you to step back clean, no punches, no punching after the bell. Wash your heads. I'm going to be watching that closely. Wash your low blows. Any questions here? Any questions here? Touch gloves. Let's go. Touch gloves. Back to your corner. Come out of the bell. Back to your corner. Come out of the bell.
So we are ready to go. And I'll tell you, the height
ready,
difference
Stu?
Looks a lot greater when these two are face-to-face than it did in that graphic that's all only 2 inches taller. Wow.
All right, let's
over
the ring.
Tacky, but he towers over him, Richard.
Yeah, it was actually very dramatic, the difference when you saw them head-to-head. So Lau will try to use some of his physical advantages here in terms of height and reach against Tacky, and it's going to be very important for him to fight a certain style of fight. I think style and whoever can dictate the fight style.
And we have seen a couple of different Ben Tacky's come to dance. He was rather passive and let Santana dictate the fight. He managed to lose the first 9 rounds in the process before a dramatic come-from-behind knockout in round number 10. And then against the Nevada, he was much more the aggressor and did dictate the tempo. It was very impressive in that way.
Well, against Santana, he was throwing one punch at a time. He just kept waiting and waiting. And even he admitted that he knew he was losing that fight. But he was determined to get Santana, which he eventually did, although he was just about to lose a lot of money. So they went back and worked on making him more of an active fighter, throwing combinations, especially when he gets close to an opponent. He does get an opponent in range of boxing. He'll not just throw one punch during it, he'll get the best of combinations, which can certainly unleash them against Leha.
Lau, on the other hand, has a pretty good reason for his 3 losses. He says, I fought left-handers, but I didn't know they were left-handed.
All 3 losses against the southpaws, and he probably might have been a managerial contract, whether that becomes to have no more southpaws, or at least if I do tell me. Now, however, feels that the blueprint for beating that tactic is basically established by Edwin Santana, which was to move, use lateral movement, get in and out when possible, throw fire off combinations quickly, 1, 2, 3, 4 punches, and then get back out and start boxing for long range. And that's what he's doing here in round number 1.
And rather effective so far. Wants to work behind the jab, and so far he's at least attempting to execute his game. He's got that cross.
says on amongst the Team Freedom fighters, he's considered the American fighter. I mean, this is a guy, while he is from Havana, he came here when he was 4 years old.
So he does, even within the confines of that team and that stable, feel as though he's kind of an outsider. Resist the urge to fight the way he normally does. Just go out there and really fight him.
That's not a big mistake. That is nothing if not strong. But hit that round. Goes into this fight unawed by his opponent, Ben Tackey. He feels that this fight is just as much his to win as it is Tackey's.
Well, pretty much I'm going to be working with my jab, feeling him out. I'm going to have him looking for me. And I know I'm a much faster fighter than he is, so I'm gonna try to frustrate him and cause his corner to tell him to come in and lose his defense, open up where I can catch him with a good shot.
Well, part one of that game plan, I thought he executed very well.
Cuando defendé, subo las manos para arriba.
That will see if he, however, can resist the temptation.
Ya,
even he said
that he's
very
tough.
He said, you know,
no
if, I'm going to box him and I'm going to make a move tonight, but I want to exchange with him if that happens. That can be a mistake with Ben.
And the other thing that he has to think about, and he told us he was thinking about, is he has not gone his distance.
Gave it to Lau, but
yeah,
it was
I did too.
Quite
Listen,
close.
That's all you have to do.
Can you open up the audience?
Stay
like
close to him,
on
and he will fight you, and you'll knock him out.
When you start to get close to him, start with your jab. Use the jab before you start throwing your right hand, okay?
Left no ma ona ke jab no ma right on
right
eh onu
yes okay. Very good
right.
You'll not
four right take it seconds out.
Center so that the public can come and watch for free. They do that with the Azuma Nelson fights. Only two sports there. Ben Tacky.
Now you're getting to get him with a good left hook right hand there.
Well, Tacky finally started getting off with his power in that round. Missing a lot of punches, but eventually landing with that powerful right of his, and you see Lau really give way at that point. Lau just visibly sagged. Here he smiled and thought to himself, I'm sure, well, that's what everyone's been talking about, that power. At the end of the round, Tacky was coming very fast, coming at Hicklett Lau. This is when I said he was going right hand crazy. He was actually setting himself up with his left hand on the rope. Referee should have warned him about that. He was getting extra leverage with that left hand by putting it on the rope.
I
really see a different Ben Tacky since the fight. It was almost like a slap in the face to him, literally. Yeah, big wake-up call as to what he had to do. And he had to be a lot more active in fights. Sit there, wait to get your power to eventually get you off the hook. He did that night, but if he kept fighting like that, he'd get further opponents. He didn't know.
attacking, turning the tenor of this fight in the last round. Big round for him. Now took the Hickman loud, trying to get the fight back in his style again. He had him in round one for about a round and a half before Tappy began cutting down the distance.
Right, right, right. Hey, right.
Next time he has some McGregor, he's going to
cluster. Every night at 10 on Fox Sports Net, it's Fox Sports News Primetime. All the scores, all the highlights, all the breaking stories, covering your hometown team 7 nights a week. We're there. Fox Sports News Primetime, every night at 10. Check your local listings.
All right, Ben Tacky had a big round in round four, and he's utilizing a little clever move here that the referee is not warning him about, and that's by utilizing the ropes to add to his power and leverage. He balances himself there. But that's not really showing what he was trying to punch off the ropes. He landed some effective punches earlier than that by using the ropes.
Use that jab. Close to him, use that jab.
So we're just about set to go to round number five. Hicklett Lau, after a very effective first round, is now starting to feel the sting of the punches of Ben Tacky. This is round five, the scheduled change. First fight of all, it'll be Ben Tacky and Hicklett Lau. Out of Havana, Cuba, but living for a long time here in Miami. The program tracks. Wow, excellent first round. Tacky starting to narrow the gap in the second round and six that time.
Punches, if they're both landing, he's going to lose every time. He can get there.
set. Takis is a different fighter in the last two fights. Coming to the end of round number five, Ben Takis has swung this fight very much in his favor. Look at that, round number six. Coming out.
Right, right. I got it. That's it. That's it. Fine.
48-47 Takis. You turn up the audio there in Takis' corner. 47. Yeah.
Move on.
Taki, you have to move it on him faster. Behind the jab, let the body come in. Don't look for his head. Taki, don't go for his head. Come in at his body.
Yeah.
Go ahead, Ray.
Ole, emusun, ko bushimo, otole ekume kume chon. Okay, well, I'm a conyo no, she no came on. Oh, now she no, man, she away and I know. Oh, he's finished. Eh? Bob Mo Bushi no cabin. Bushi no cabin.
Number six now, and Ben Takis having established himself in this fight. Joe Goosen in his corner wants him to go to the body, work the body in this fight. We'll see how well he minds his corner's advice. Here comes Takis by the corner. That's the way I have it too. Exactly what Ben Takis the last 3 rounds.
Right.
Now, now, running on the front of round number two, although really the beginning of that going in the way, but since then it's been all fine. Joe Goosen told Ben Takis didn't work for the faith, although he hasn't thrown a body punch for this one. About it.
Just been crushed by that set
in the light heavyweight division, and it is for the NABF light heavyweight title. Montel Griffin and the last-minute replacement, Eric Harding. Harding, though, nothing if not confident going into this main event.
Now there's Tacky, who's trying to take advantage of his power.
Not 2.5 minutes. Joe Cousin,
as he did in the Edwin Santana fight, telling him to fight for 3 minutes. This was a fight you're going to see a great punch. There it is, right-hand shot. This was in the 10th round after Tacky had lost 9 consecutive rounds to Santana and pulled this fight out with that one shot. That's the kind of power, an explosion that he has in that right fist.
Right now, it seems the only thing that could beat Ben Tacky is Ben Tacky.
No! Raymond McRae, who was one of the trainers of Ben Tacky, was arguing vehemently with the referee after that last round. The fight for Ring 8 was the one of the ones in no uncertain terms. You know, to forget about that, and they've taken Raymond McRae and shot him off 5 miles back.
Atiende, Higley. Atiéndeme. Atiende. No, no puedes dejar esta pelea tú. Un puesto. Entonces, ¿por qué te estás bajando con ese hombre en la esquina? Coño. 100 años de tener que hacer un Vamos conmigo.
No, I don't want to. I don't want to talk to Tacky in any.
Well, you can't talk to Tacky, and he has nothing.
But then he asked that interpreter question.
Let's go,
let's go.
I wouldn't have this much time.
Let's go. Get the stool out.
Round number 8. Red Wild, Ben Tacky, Blau, and Purple. Tacky in the red, green, and yellow. Thank you.
I'd rather use the brakes early and fill it. See what? Yeah, that's a good shot.
Cycles out. 9. 10. 9 rounds. Coming up. Let's go.
The power of Ben Tacky's right hand. There you see it. Right hand sent the head of Hicklin Lau back over the top rope. And Hicklin Lau did a lot of work there, Rob. For the first 2 minutes of the whole round, Tacky came on strong in that last minute. Thank you.
if I hear, I'm going to stay down here. I'm assuming Tag can win the decision. Doesn't go for it.
10th and final round coming up. 10th and final round.
Touch him up. Touch. Back up. Let's go. Last round. Vamos.
10th and final round. Now, Tekken hits left live. You can see him attacking. You don't stay in harm's way here to win this fight. Keep in mind, however, in the scoring that Tekken did have a point. He did get a long fight. For excessive holding. And he may have lost the first two rounds. So now, if he can close the show big here with the maybe put himself within the hailing distance.
At this table is that Tacky won it reasonably handily. We'll come back, find out for sure right after this.
Yeah. All right.
Now what? Yeah, sitting, yeah.
Incidentally, Barry, that's Shannon Briggs over in his corner. Right.
I actually had this fairly close. I had this 3-point fight. That's what I had. Well, it's about time to change the copy on some of these.
Thank you.
We welcome you back to the Miccosukee Gaming Pavilion. We're here in Miami, Florida, while we await the decision. We remind you, it's hardcore football on Fox Sports Net. Ronnie Lott, Bill Moss, Ron Pitts, they bring you turf talk from the toughest guys in the NFL. Hardcore X's and O's, hardcore blood, sweat, and tears. Hardcore football, it's for the hardcore fan. That's Hardcore Football Tuesday at 8 on Fox Sports Net. Well, let's find out the official results of this one. We take you up to the center of the ring and Thomas Triber.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 10 rounds of boxing, we go to the scorecards and we have a unanimous decision. Both judges, Stu Winston and Rick Bays, scored about 96 to 93, and Judge Rocky Young scores about 95 to 94, all in favor of your winner, Ben Wonder Taki.
So Ben Taki wins it just about the way we had it. What a surprise that is.
Major shock there. And 96-93 is also the way that I scored for Taki, the winner at the end.
So Ben Taki, once again, with a rather impressive performance. This is the guy who clearly is on the come, getting better with every outing, and that's what you want in a fighter that now has 18 victories without a loss.